Robert here from the College Investor. How are you guys doing today? I am excited to give you a sneak peek of what Quicken 2017 for Mac is all about. So I was really excited because last year I heard that Intuit had sold Quicken off to a new company. And this new company really promises to really make Quicken what it deserves to be on the Mac. Because for any longtime Quicken users, you know that the Mac interface has really been lacking, and they really have not put the same support and resources behind the Mac version that they had put onto the Windows version. And with the newest release of the Quicken 2017 for Windows, they had some great features in there, and I was really excited to see what the Mac version had to offer. And honestly, guys, I'm still kind of depressed on it. I don't know if it's worth the price tag of $75 for what you get in the Mac version. That's kind of sad, but you know, there's hopes. It's a clean interface. I can see they've done some things. So maybe next year they're going to keep moving this thing in the right direction. But let's kind of dive in and I'll show you the basics here. And you can kind of see it right here as we start. So this is your home screen. I added in a couple of my accounts. I started as a fresh install because I've deleted it for you guys. So everyone knows I've been using Personal Capital, and it really does what I'm looking for. So I just added in a couple of my accounts here to kind of give this a shot. I added a checking account, a credit card, and a brokerage account there, so that we could kind of go through this. So you can kind of see like you're spending by category. They have a couple different things here. You can see you're spending over time. You can see your net income every single month. You can dive in and you can see like it breaks it down really nice. Tells you exactly what you're spending your money on. I mean, you can do the same thing on the account level. So you can come here, you can see like you're spending on the account level, and then you can break it open there as well. So that's nice. I mean, it's clean. It runs fast. It's really great about categorizing everything. So when it comes to your banking and just keeping your accounts organized, like this is helpful. This is nice. When it comes to investing, this is what you get. You basically get a portfolio holding. It shows what your portfolio is in there. It shows what you have, what your basis is, any gains and losses. So this is an update. This is an upgrade from the first version of Quicken for Mac. Didn't even have this cost basis and stuff in it. It only had the value. So, you know, I think last year's had this. So this is a nice bit of update. And then it just has transactions. So this is the biggest area where Quicken 2017 is lacking. It doesn't give you anything you need when it comes to managing your investments. And so when you're thinking of a $75 price tag, you're thinking of like this should be like Quicken Basic should be like $30 or $40. And like when you're getting to $75, you should be like at investing or maybe even home and business. Because when I think of what I get on Personal Capital, I'm being able to see like my asset allocation and my holdings by class. And you have so much more robustness that you're able to do with your investing. And it's just not here in Quicken for Mac yet, which is really disappointing because it's like, look, you got all this space here on this bar. So let's like add some of this stuff in here and get it rocking and rolling. Like you already do it in the Windows version. One of my favorite features in Quicken for Windows was being able to look at your asset allocation, and it tells you the dollar amounts you need to rebalance to get to your target. So there are real tools that are lacking here in this investing version that really don't make it any better than the free tools that you can get by using Personal Capital. So big disappointment here, big disappointment. The other thing I saw that was really cool on Quicken for Windows is that you could connect your home and you could have it track to Zillow. So Zillow would update your home price. And it's actually what Mint has been doing for a while and Personal Capital does it. But you know what? Here, I can try to add my house and it's only manual accounts for assets. So they don't let you connect your house. You can't keep track of any of that automatically. So that's kind of a bummer as well. Like there's still a lot of manual stuff in here. There's still not a lot of features when it comes into this Quicken for Mac version. But you know, you do get reports. So like here's my account summaries. You can go by like category spending. You could go and have your tax schedule. So these reports are great. They've been a staple. I use this tax report every single year when I do my taxes. They've been a staple of Quicken for a long time, and I'm a fan of the reports they generate. Their budgeting tool is pretty nice too. I think they have one of the better budgeting tools out there. If you want to have it build you a budget and follow it and shows you the over under, but if you're going to do the budget, you have to be very diligent on categorizing your expenses appropriately. And they also have the bill minders. You can have your bill reminders come up. It tries to know your automated stuff automatically. I have never used it, but I know a lot of people find value with like mint.com's bill minder. So I think something like this could be useful, but I haven't been able to see the implementation of it yet. And then finally, they have their calendar, which just kind of shows your transactions by day. I actually have never used the calendar before, so I was checking it out and I liked it. For this one feature, it shows you your portfolio gain and loss by day, which is always fun to see. I like all these transactions here, but I don't know why all the transactions are coded green. Because these are all negative. So yeah, I want to spend $125 at Target. You'd think that the income would be green and like the expenses would be red so that you could see like if you're spending a lot of money on one day or you're getting a bunch of income on one day. So I think it's weird how they have that laid out, and I tried to customize it, but like it doesn't let me do anything except delete it, you know? So, that was kind of a bummer as well. And then you have your account alerts. So I got a large deposit and had a large purchase. Well, the account alerts are nice. And in Quicken for Mac, they also show up in the notification center. So if you have Quicken for Mac running in the background, you'll get these notifications, which could be handy, right? If you're not in a good habit of checking your account balances every single week, having those notifications pop up could be very handy. So really, that's all there is to it. Like, I wish I could show you more about Quicken for Mac, because I was hoping for more. So sad to say, like it's useful, it's helpful. I like the clean interface of it. I like the speed. It integrates with all my accounts flawlessly, at least the ones that I tried. But where it's really lacking is it's in that investing section. It's in those connectivity, like in taking care of your assets. It doesn't have anything here. Like, this was like the biggest disappointment for me. And it's like probably the reason why I would not recommend anyone with investments purchase Quicken for Mac for $75. I think that is too much for what you get, because you can get everything that Quicken currently does for Mac for free if you go online to Personal Capital or Mint.com. It has the same stuff on there. Personal Capital does a little bit better. I'd love to see Personal Capital do something more like with your exact cost basis and stuff, but you know, they're free. So like, you can't beat free for what you get when you're trying to compare it to a $75 option. So I hope you found this review valuable. I hope it helps you understand a little bit more what you're getting with Quicken for Mac. And hopefully we'll see Quicken continue to iterate and make better versions of this going forward in the future. All right, guys, this has been Robert from The College Investor. I appreciate you taking the time to watch this review. You can read the full article on the blog, as well as get some links to compare prices to get the best deal for Quicken for Mac. And please subscribe to our channel. If you're not a subscriber yet, I'd love you to be so that you can stay up to date on our latest videos. All right, guys, I hope you have a great week, and I will see you next week.